Thank you. organ was built in 1974 and was the vision of Elliot Wold, who was the choral conductor and chairperson of the music department at the time. There was an increase in organ study across the country in the 1960s and 70s as more music programs began to offer organ instruction. The instrument would also be used to accompany choral and instrumental ensembles. The music department wanted an organ with a good, solid design to be used for instruction, recitals, and practice. It would be a movable console with a flexible cable and allowed to be placed anywhere on the stage. Charles Hendrickson of Hendrickson Organ Company in St. Peter, Minnesota, was selected as the builder in 1973. The installation of the organ was completed in 1975 and cost the university $34,000. These are just copies from the archives of the letter choosing Hendrickson as the organ and the check that was sent to his bank in St. Peter. Today, it would cost $500,000 to replace this instrument with a new one. The organ dedication concert was held in March of 1976. Faculty organist Catherine Mowen played the concert that included the music of two Czechoslovakian composers, French music by Couperin and Messiaen, a Bach chorale prelude, and several American tunes arranged for organ by American composers. Catherine was quoted in the news bureau of the university announcing the concert. "The organ is an instrument that has challenged composers through the ages. Now our students can experience their compositions." Elliot Wold said, "The organ has opened up all kinds of new literature doors for the choir and for instrumental groups." As we look to the past for the organ's purpose and function, we find documentation in photographs from the university archives of Catherine teaching. There are photos of her playing the instrument and more from the dedication concert. She taught organ students techniques for the organ for repertoire and church services. Before this organ was installed, Catherine taught at Ezekiel Lutheran Church in River Falls. Catherine was my hero, and she taught for 32 years at River Falls and retired in 2006. David Milne appointed me faculty organist in August of 2006. Catherine was a mentor, colleague, and friend of many people, and I count myself fortunate to be one of them. The pipe organ in Abbott Hall visibly distinguishes UW-River Falls from other similar-sized campuses in the University of Wisconsin system. Students learn organ technique, repertoire, service playing, and the art of collaboration. The skills help them obtain positions in area churches where they provide leadership and accompanying roles in worship. There is a shortage of young organists to replace organists in churches that use the organ, especially in small communities and rural areas. After my first year at River Falls, I asked the son of the organ builder to write about the instrument's condition. In 2007, that's quite a while ago, he wrote, "Nowadays there are more reliable electronics than from 30 years ago. Everything would look and sound the same except for the occasional dead notes presently that exist from time to time. But the wiring would be new in the console and a small fiber optic cable would replace most of the large cable exiting the console." To do this project in 2007, 2007 would be around $39,000. A quarter of the business of that company was doing updates to older instruments. Organ construction continued, and each year we would tune the organ, try and fix problems that cropped up. We've had excellent players come through the ranks at this school, and students find jobs in area churches. Each year, I receive several calls from ministers and pastors in western Wisconsin and eastern Minnesota looking for students to play the organ. In addition to teaching and performing on campus, we travel to other sites to see and hear organs. We attend professional meetings and meet other organists and colleagues. We give organ demonstrations and let other people try out the organ. Students assist me in my programs, perform their own recitals, and attend concerts together. In addition to these activities, the organ is used in holiday concerts with choirs, instrumental ensembles, and many collaborative settings at the school. You can see we have a lot of fun, just away from campus too. Music majors and non-music majors have an opportunity to study organ during their time on campus. It's a prime time to learn the instrument while having access to organs for practice and performance. River Falls' proximity to the Twin Cities increases attendance at concerts featuring great artists and instruments. Now, this brief history and description of the organ program at River Falls is to help you understand the need for restoring and updating the instrument that was designed and built specifically for this hall.
Thank you. But it's a lot of fun. I enjoy the organ. One of the reasons I wanted to learn organ is because I'm passionate about church music, both choral and instrumental. It was actually my church pastor who first encouraged me to pursue the organ. So I also know from others' testimonies that working as a church musician can be an extremely rewarding job, even for a college student, and provides a significant source of extra income, while also being a great way of gaining valuable experience playing in public. So all in all, I'm very happy to be able to broaden my skills here at River Falls with the organ, and I want to thank you so much for coming to our concert today. It means a lot. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Isn't it fun to see these young people play so well? It's my turn again. So when we talk about this organ, we say, why fix the organ? It sounds pretty good because we keep fixing it up and doing the little things you have to do. Sometimes Jenny Hansen, the music department secretary, and I feel like EMTs for the pipe organ. We call 911, and the organ technician comes out and solves the problem and resuscitates the instrument, and we're good to go for another semester. But pipe organs are complicated instruments, and they need maintenance by specialized organ builders, which is expensive. We have had to cover this organ with plastic at least 3 times during my tenure when work was done in the hall so that dust and dirt doesn't enter the pipes, because dust and dirt in pipes causes ciphers when a pipe won't stop sounding or dead notes. So we have had a proposal for updating this instrument since approximately 2010. Abbott Hall was restored quite beautifully several years ago, and we submitted the proposal to be included, but the organ was not selected to be a part of that update. So what are the problems? This is a picture of the back of the console. It has bad, outdated wiring. You can see the maze of wires, both in the back of the console and up by the pipes, behind the pipes. All of these wires and configurations could be replaced by a circuit board that would probably be the size of a large envelope with today's technology. Other fixes we have taken care of are, last year, the day before school started, Evan texted me and said, there's no power in the organ. The organ doesn't play. So we called 911 and the technician came out, and there was a short in this umbilical cord connection. This cord, this big blue fire hose cord, brings power to the console. And after all these years, which is quite a long time, nothing had happened like that, but he soldered it together so we had power and we kept going. Another problem has to do with the bottom left picture where you see we did a Scotch tape fix on the mixture for the pedal. It goes on with every single piston that you press. I mean, so then you have this huge mixture in the pedal plate. So by putting some tape on it, it doesn't flop down every time you push a piston. I'm just showing you some of the various things. In addition, we've had dead notes over the years. There's an old relay system that connects the pipes to the electrical part of the console. On the bottom right shows some wooden pipes that were split, and they were mended with some kind of putty or sealant, and they really do need to be replaced. What is our goal? We want to update the console with modern technology and multiple memory levels. This organ has 10 general pistons, which means you can press a button and change all the different sounds quickly. It's easy to use more than 10 pistons in one song. This becomes a problem in recitals when students have to change the pistons between numbers. We're taking care of that today while I talk. Evan is taking care of changing pistons. The updated instrument would probably have at least 100 memory levels where students could save their registrations. We would finish the original design of the organ by adding a crescendo pedal, which is planned for, and completing the Krummhorn stop on the swell to sound at the 8-foot pitch as well as the 16-foot pitch. We would also complete that pesky mixture stop on the pedal so that it would play on the whole manual. There would be a complete cleaning and repair of the instrument. This instrument is probably very dirty. I mean, every 50 years, everybody needs a bath or something. We need to clean the pipes. So the cost is approximately $125,000. I think we've raised $10,000 with just one concert last spring, and that was without what I would consider a large major donor. So I think we've done pretty well with one concert. And I'm quite pleased with that. And really today, if you don't give a dime, that's not the importance. The importance is to get the word out that it's an important instrument. As I said before, restoring this instrument would set UW-River Falls apart from other universities the same size in Wisconsin. Some have gotten rid of their organs and organ study altogether, including La Crosse and Stevens Point. Pipe organs require dedication, patience, and determination to learn how to make music on the instruments. It's an art form like no other. The pipe organ in Abbott Hall is a symbol that UW-River Falls supports art and music and desires the use of the instrument in teaching, performance, and collaboration with soloists and ensembles. It benefits everybody, the students, the teachers, and the community. Thank you for coming today to learn about the Hendrickson organ and hear it in concert with other instruments. Thank you.
Good afternoon and welcome, and thank you for joining us for this fantastic concert, Organ Plus Showcase, featuring Dr. Laura Edmond, our students, our community members, our faculty, here as a part of the Music and Stage and Screen Arts Department at the University of Wisconsin, River Falls. I'm David Milne, I'm chair of the Music and Stage and Screen Arts Department, and I'd just like to offer a few notes of thanks and gratitude, and highlight some important information for you this afternoon about our organ and its development. First of all, I would like to just acknowledge what a fantastic concert this has been this afternoon, featuring music ranging from 15th century works by Gabrielli to 20th century jazz, featuring our faculty, our students, our community members, and the continuing tradition of organ excellence here at UW-River Falls. Could we just all acknowledge what a fantastic concert this has been this afternoon? And thank you for being here and supporting music, supporting live music in our program at our university in the College of Arts and Sciences and the Music and Stage and Screen Arts Department. I was appointed to the faculty here at UW-River Falls in 1990. I'm in my 33rd year, my 14th year as the department chair, my fifth term as a department chair. I've seen a lot over the years. I've seen a lot of changes, and Dr. Edmond's offered the opportunity to provide a few perspectives. I promise I'll keep my remarks short. It's been a beautiful concert, and I believe that the music should speak for itself. That said, I'd like to just acknowledge the faculty, because having been here as long as I have, I've worked with both Catherine Moen and Laura Edmond as faculty and colleagues, and I'd like to just honor the memory of Catherine Moen for her establishment of a great tradition of organ study here at UW-River Falls, as well as the continuation and development of that fantastic tradition with Dr. Laura Edmond. Could we please honor both Catherine and Laura? When we attend a concert like this, we think about what we value, and you've obviously chosen to value the performing arts, music, the experience of sharing music together. And that might be my cue. we can look at value in a number of ways, and our society tends to look at value in terms of money. And certainly it takes money to fund a music and stage and screen arts department, or an organ program, or this concert hall. And if we think about it in a few different ways, what do we value? You know, you see in the program notes that the organ has 1,258 pipes. Well, if each one of those pipes is worth approximately $100, then we could take $100 for each one of these pipes and fund the restoration of our organ. You've seen in the program notes that the value of the organ is about $600,000. That's a large amount of money. That's an amazing instrument that's been built into the Abbott Concert Hall. Dr. Edmond noted that in 2019, we renovated the entire William Abbott Concert Hall, a beautiful state-of-the-art facility with amazing acoustics. You're hearing and experiencing this live this afternoon. It's a beautiful place to perform and share music. Unfortunately, over time, over the decades, our university system has received less funding from the state of Wisconsin over the decades. This is a fact. So it becomes harder to advocate for funds to update, improve, renovate, repair, scotch tape our instruments and our equipment. And so I would like to highlight that the importance of restoring this amazing instrument, the value of that is tremendous, because it's beyond the money. You can see by the performance of our excellent students, Cassidy, Josephine, and Evan, performing brilliantly for you this afternoon, the value that this instrument, this program, and the university provides. So as we speak to what we value, I encourage you to consider valuing the arts, valuing our organ program, Dr. Edmond's students, the experience of coming here this afternoon. You see a donor card here that you can contribute to the organ fund here at UW-River Falls. We established this in the spring, and we're continuing. As Dr. Edmund noted, we have about $10,000 towards a goal of about, well, it says $125,000, but it keeps going up every year. I'll tell you, as the department chair, the cost increases every year. So I'll say $150,000. And we want to have contributions from as many folks as possible, and any amount is greatly appreciated. There's a number of ways to donate. There's a number of ways, a number of amounts to donate, ranging from small to high, and we value and are grateful for any contribution you can give. So please pick up one of these cards. They're both at the back of the hall, as well as up here by the organ. And I'd like to remind you that Dr. Edmund has asked everyone to come look at the organ after the concert. So I would love for you to just come up and look at this amazing instrument. We have these donor cards here, as well as some literature about the organ you can pick up. It's an amazing instrument. And along with our pianos, you know, our beautiful concert Steinway D pianos, these are some of the best pianos in the upper Midwest of the United States. They're regulated by our piano technician. Touring pianists come through all the time and remark on what beautiful and amazing pianos we have. Each one of these pianos is worth about $150,000. So the organ is worth about five of those pianos. Again, you can start thinking about, you know, the value of the organ here and how tremendous it is in terms of its inclusion here at UW-River Falls. It's a distinctive instrument. It's a distinctive program in the UW system. There are very few organ study programs here in the state of Wisconsin, especially in a public-funded state university. And we should all be very, very proud of Dr. Evan, her students, our faculty, for performing. So I'll shorten my remarks here at this moment. So thank you for your time. Would love to see you up here on stage. Be happy to speak with you more about the Organ Development Fund, as with Dr. Edmund. Before we go, could we just give a few rounds of applause for folks? How about a round of applause for our 7 faculty performing for you for free this afternoon? Yeah, thank you, faculty. Thank you for your donation and contributions. And thank you for our community members, John Potter and Mary Schneider, for performing so beautifully and brilliantly this afternoon. How about a hand for our community members performing? And our students, Cassidy, Evan, and Josephine, as well as our students recording the concert. I'd like to just mention that since the pandemic, the department has recorded and posted many of our concerts on our YouTube channel, and as a part of our virtual concert series, this concert will be a part of that, so you'll be able to watch and enjoy this concert again on YouTube. But not to emphasize that, rather, let's emphasize the work of our excellent students. How about a hand for our students this afternoon?